What's up, YouTube? It's Jerzo101 Productions with a Dark Souls New Game Plus Plus co-op playthrough. I'm going to be doing this with Major Muffin 78, or Drew, as I like to call him around these parts. So, we just beat the game a couple minutes ago. And if the music and such is a little loud here, don't worry, I'm going to turn it down so you can hear Drew and I much better than we are currently. I kind of made a character based around, like, magic and, buffing my weapons and such. Ended up doing a lot of damage that way, and I got some medium, style armor. Not quite so heavy, but on the lighter end either. As you can see, I finished the game, again, at level 152 in about 90 hours, so. Let's jump into this opening cutscene. Hopefully we'll meet up with Drew. So now we're back at the beginning of the game here. In the Undead Asylum.
Yes, indeed.
Indeed.
The dark sign brands the undead. And in this land, the undead are corralled and led to the north. Where they are locked away to await the end of the world.
Thus we meet our unlikely hero. Me!
This is your fate.
He's so good.
Drew is also working through the Undead Asylum, so we can meet up at Firewing. The Undead Parish and work together to take out the first boss. But for now, I'm on my own. Yep. It's that one guy! I think he's a prince.
Kill that dude.
I did kill that dude. Killed that dude many times. I wonder if he was helping me. What does he have? What does he have to gain?
4 hits to kill him. 4.
Oh, the final. Yeah, okay.
Not hard.
Oh, wow, it totally gave me the stats I had when I beat the game. Well, let's get going here. As you can see, I kind of look ridiculous. I'm wearing this helmet for defense. I actually like to wear this big hat to give me kind of a goofy anime look. But that's beside the point. And Marty. It's in simple things. The reason we're doing this in New Game Plus Plus is because we already did New Game Plus. It'd be kind of weird to start in the middle. And we don't have to worry about getting items and grinding as much. We just have to worry about going through the game. So it's a little bit faster for you as the viewer. Before I go on, here's my equipment here. So I had +5 giants everything because I wanted the most defense, and then I realized people who use that are tools, so I stopped doing that. But I only wear the legs.
I only use that for bosses. Really the idea. It's really big PvP players.
Right. Actually, I'm gonna turn.
We can level up now.
Turn the volume down here.
30.
Alright, yeah. Turning everything down here so you can hear Drill a bit better. So, back to my inventory. So yeah, giant leggings +5, giant gauntlets +5. I did the Easter armor +5 because I just wanted to look cooler. It's not as good as giants +5, I just look cooler. And big cat +5 because, you know, this actually offers the most magic defense of any headgear in the game, from what I know, I think. I look cooler with it. I don't know. Leave a comment if you think I look cool with the giant's helmet. And then I have the crest shield. I was actually rolling around with the blood shield for a while because it gave me all the resistances, but the crest shield ended up having better defense in most departments. And I actually have
magic, man.
Magic, for sure. The 80 in magic was a good swing factor. And I actually have a good array of weapons I actually use. So I had this idea that the Greatsword of Artorias was like the best weapon in the game, so I made that like pretty quickly in my original game. Realized that the magic damage, physical damage split is kinda bad. And then I made... I actually don't have them on me. I had the Great Scythe... I made it a Great Scythe plus 15, I think. Or no, I made it a Great Scythe, a Magic Great Scythe. And I went along with that for a while, and then I decided to make it a plus 15, then I'll maybe get plus get another Great Scythe and make that enchanted. Then I realized that I wasn't really feeling that, and I wanted a katana. So I joined the Forest Hunters Covenant as well in that game, and I bought two Washing Poles, one plus 15, then one to enchanted plus 5. And I've been kind of rolling around with the enchanted one, or the plus 15 one because I can buff it, but without even buffing, the enchanted one is better, for sure. But the most damage I still get is from the Greatsword of Artorias. I think one of the first weapons I'm going to make is the cursed version of that, but we'll see. Anyway, let's keep going. How many souls these guys get in the game plus? Let's find out. I didn't actually look. Let's see, 129, okay, wow.
I need to just bust through the beginning of this game. Like,
yeah.
No issue. Not even funny.
Yeah, the first time I did New Game Plus, I did the jumping attack on the... Yeah, I can kind of see him from here. The demon, and beat him in one hit. It's kind of awesome. See,
I didn't even bother doing that, I'm just gonna kill this thing. Just gonna run up and kill this bugger.
Well, I like having the satisfaction of doing that, so let's see if I can do.
Oh no, I got evaded, I'm pretty sure.
That's pretty quick. And actually right here you kinda see it's pretty safe, then you actually take a couple steps back and then tilt the camera upward. You can see our little friend there. We're not gonna fight him just yet, as I already said. I need to rest there. I don't care. What's up, buddy? I'm not gonna grab either one of those items, because even in... Well, I'll grab this to show you. Even in New Game Plus Plus, it still gives you the same exact items. Which is why we're doing it in New Game Plus Plus, is because we don't have to worry about them, because we know what they are.
Entity acquired.
And we already have them. I don't need to really talk to this guy except for the key, so I'll do that. What's up? I probably shouldn't skip that. This guy is dying. He gives you the task of ringing the two bells.
Regrettably, I have failed in my mission. But perhaps you can keep the torch lit. There is an old saying in my family. Thou who art undead art chosen. In thine exile.
Most of the games. So basically just gives you all the quests you're gonna need.
When thou
a little bit.
Awakening. Gives you the act one
the
stuff.
Undead, thou shalt know. Well, now you know. And I can die with hope in my heart. Oh, one more thing. Here, take this. Now I must bid. I would hate to harm you after death. So go now.
Okay.
Bonfire here.
He's gonna commit seppuku. Or suicide.
About to get 2,000 vitality.
Oh yeah. Drew has stupid amounts of vitality.
Copious amounts of vitality.
Yep.
1924. That's what it is right now.
Yeah, I have, like, I finished the game here with, like, 1,300. Yeah, 1,346. What are you doing?
Sorry, I pushed from my, wiped my face, and hit the mic, and made a really weird sound.
It did make a really weird sound.
Yeah, sorry about that.
It's okay. A-okay. Alright, so...
Is that dead?
Alright, the boss here. Let's see if I can one-shot this motherfucker. Now, buffed with this spell, this sword does the most damage for me. Let's see what I can do! Ooh! That's about 80% or so. Hey. Alright, three hits. So, and we got the humanity, so let's head to Firelink.
They're getting invaded left and right.
I'm not human, so. Because my ending killed me. And if you look over there, there's Snuggly with Crow's nest, which I might visit here.
Cool.
Get some nice upgrading materials.
In the ancient legends,
watch this cutscene here.
That one day an undead shall be chosen.
Snatch.
To leave the undead asylum in pilgrimage. To the land of the ancient lord.
What the heck? That guy can just hit me through a shield. With his weapon.
Lord.
This is all magic damage or something. Oh, he got me. Wait, but my shield blocks magic damage. Why did that all just hurt me?
What the...
Jake? I don't...
I'm worried, Jake. What happened?
That attacked me.
What was the weapon?
I don't understand.
What the weapon looked like?
That was like a scythe-looking thing, and it was had some enchantment on it.
It was a scythe?
Yeah, I think so. It was like a handheld scythe, a one-handed scythe.
Oh, it was very... it wasn't actually like a full-length scythe. It was like a small little curved blade.
Yeah.
Okay, I know what that weapon is. I think it's called a Chotel. Or Chotel, I don't really know how to pronounce it. It's heavy attack. It ignores your shield.
God. You gotta just kick my ass with that thing.
That makes sense. So, we're here in Firelink. I kind of forgot to establish some ground rules, I guess. Or a timeline for this, I guess. Not really a timeline, but... You'll see what I mean here. For one... All you're going to see on these videos is us going through dungeons or areas or whatever to fight bosses. You're not going to see us grinding. Unless I post that as something separate. I don't know, like grinding for Demon Titanite and making certain weapons. You'll only see the progress. Oh, I think we're off. Not going to fight Dark Sun Gwendolyn because I already have all the stuff. Not like the New Game Plus.
I'm part of the Covenant.
He's part of the Covenant. Covenant. Well, the game's over. Started over again, so I don't think you're actually... Totally.
Yeah,
hey, you're totally...
Oh, I am. Yeah.
Yeah, you're totally still in the Covenant, actually. So, there's that. What else? Not going to be doing a lot of PvPing, because... As a lot of people enjoy PvP in this game, I think it's kind of ridiculous. A little broken.
Jake and I are not the biggest fans of it.
No, I mean, we'll deal with invaders. We will deal with them.
Oh, I don't mind dealing with them. For the most part. Sometimes it gets annoying, though.
Yes. You might see this in places like the Duke's Archives.
Duke's Archives is awful.
Because that is a place where people love to invade. I'm going to try to continue my idea of working on my intelligence and finding a weapon that can balance in both magic and physical damage, that maybe I won't have to worry about buffing so I can free up one of my attunement slots, but we'll see. So, our next objective from here is to get to the Undead Parish, as that's where everything starts. So let's go there. Actually, let me rest first and then level up.
Hey, I would not recommend becoming human until you get to the Undead Parish.
Of course.
Because it's gonna be the hassle. I've just got invaded like three or four times. Got two of the guys, but I only got the last one. Yeah, the guy messaged me and he's like, "Oh, by the way, my weapon ignores all this bullshit." And I'm like, well, I figured that one out, man.
Yeah. At least he was nice about it.
He was. He wasn't just a prick about it. The most part, when people send me messages in this game, they're not, like, being dicks.
Yep.
Just like, huh.
Yeah. We're on the Xbox, obviously, so we deal with a lot of bullshit. in terms of people being assholes.
Yeah.
Let's see if I can run around without that sword. Let's see here. Let's put on this guy. And let's attune some stuff real quick. Magic. See you later. Don't need you. Let's put on something like, I don't know. I got some stuff. I don't know what I'm gonna put on. Put on the other soul spear. It's always good. That's fun, Remedy.
What about Taurus Demon?
Wait, you're already there?
His ass. Yeah, dude.
Oh,
I'm telling you.
I was gonna...
Busted through the first part of this game.
So we could do it together, but never mind! Alright, so I guess I'm gonna be fighting the Taurus Demon by myself. So I'm gonna try to roll around without having to upgrade or buff weapons, because I like not having to change my equipment around a bunch, because I have to have my catalyst in my left hand to do that. That's kind of annoying, because I usually can... mostly use the catalyst for offense.
Beated.
And I have the 10 banishment catalyst, but I don't want to use it because obviously it halves the casting, so. And this is always a good humbling thing of when you're starting the game over. It's, I think I can still probably kill these guys in a hit. Oh, or miss. Yeah, I can kill them in a hit.
Oh, yeah, you can. Trust me.
But if I take a hit, I'll probably take some good damage, so. Aw, oh, camera angles. What is this?
Oh, the Mr. Solaire over here.
Ah, the Knight of Solaire. And the Sons of Gwyn and... batshit crazy. I'm gonna parry that, but that was on the other side of him. Can I parry this guy? He's sick if I parried that, but
Oh.
No, I'm not a parrying expert or anything.
You're the very first grind spot, Jake. It gave me like almost 2,500 souls.
Pretty good ground spot. Probably not gonna.
Play that one with the dragon?
Yes, yeah, I know what you're talking about, I'm just saying. Probably not gonna need to grind much.
Oh no, dude, I don't really give a shit about souls at this point. I got really good weapons, I'm a really high level. But for me to level up, I think I need like 150,000 something souls, like, I don't care. I'm good at this point.
Probably don't need to be. Oh, 777, number of God. Here we go. Ow. Yeah, so, like I said, I'm not a parrying expert, so I'm gonna be blocking a lot, just punishing that way. Circling around for a lot of backstabs. And PvP situations when Drew and I get invaded, I think what usually happens is Drew ends up trying to just beat the shit out of the guy, and I end up casting magic and just end up either chipping him to death or getting him cornered, and then we can just maul him.
Be good. It is really good. It's probably one of the best PvP weapons, and I use it, and I love this sword for PvP.
I don't think the sword name actually came out.
Aedo.
There you go.
I thought I said it, and again, it's Xbox Live.
Yeah, so Drew drops...
I don't know, it's gonna be the best.
If Drew drops words, I'll make sure he repeats them. I'll make sure.
Come on, Black Knight. Fighting the second Black Knight already.
Proud of you.
Oh god, you just hit me real hard.
Yes, I won't be getting a bunch of items here. The only thing you'll ever see me trying to do or buy is like arrows, because having obscene amounts of arrows is always fun.
Very useful too.
Mm-hmm. That was bad, bad parry. Whatever. Oh, forgot he was in here. What's up, bro? Yeah. I keep picking up items I know I shouldn't be. It's like I have this little, like, pattern I have to run when I start this game. That's the thing. But the thing with me, if you ever find when I if I post more RPG stuff, is I start an RPG, I play it a certain way every time.
Got to.
Kinda. Especially in Fallout, like New Vegas, like I always do the same exact thing. Every time. Like I never choose to do the bad thing, I always save the town, I always go to this area to look for stuff. Yeah. Yeah. And there's a...
Find a giant.
I believe this is where the blue tier stone ring is, but I already have it, so it doesn't matter. I'm gonna sneak up on him and stab him in the kidneys.
I'm gonna stab this giant thing in the butt. Right in his butthole.
So I'm gonna lure him out here so I can fight him. Proper. Shit. It's a little far away. I tried to. There we go.
Luge.
I got a titanite chunk. That'll be helpful later. Maybe. Okay. There's gonna be a trap here. You just gotta run up and run back and easily avoid it. You can jump over it too, I think. Donkey Kong style, but. That's always more risk for the same.
Run!
And
see any part of this game?
Open this door. Obviously, I have the master key. It's probably the only, unless you start as thief, it's like the only like key item you should start the game with, or special item. I don't remember what they're called, but down here is our
everything
friend.
It's kind of a waste, otherwise.
Yeah. Well.
Let's start with the master key. Mm-hmm. I think that'd be even decent as twin humanities.
Black Fireball is something nice because it helps you with this first boss.
That is true.
Or Divine Blessing. Divine Blessing.
But there's so many different ways to deal with that first boss, I wouldn't even say that.
I don't know, it helps though. When you're starting out, it was definitely when I first started, that was a great, good way to beat that boss. Anyway,
you
down here.
You hate yourself later if you're playing new game. If you're playing new game plus, you'll hate yourself for doing that.
It doesn't really matter. Only if you, that's what I'm saying, if you start as thief and you have to pick another thing, then yeah. If you don't
oh
start,
yeah, that's probably the next best thing.
Say if you don't start thief, then you're making a mistake by not picking the master key. And like down here, I said is a hovel, and he drops hovel's ring, which is a ring that once I picked up, I put
best
on
best ring of the game.
Maybe once I picked up and put
arguably.
On
arguably
there you go. Once I picked up and put it on, it just I never took it off. Like it's just too effective. You see a lot of people compare it with the Ring of Favorite Protection, which we'll get later, but I'm not going to use it.
That's what I'm doing right now.
Because the thing with the Ring of Favorite Protection...
Take as many rings on as possible.
Yeah. The thing with the Ring of Favorite Protection is when I first found it, I did the same thing if I paired it with hobbles and thought it was the best thing ever. And then I found it as kind of a crutch for me, and I didn't really like having it, so...
Yeah, it is kind of a crutch.
And it ties you
may
up.
May take it off in this playthrough.
Might be a good idea. Probably have the endurance to just do hobbles and be able to wear everything. Whatever armor you have. Here's our first twinkling, sparkling lizard guy. Making his return from Demon Souls, which is much easier in this game to take down than they are in Demon Souls. Now, I'm only saying this from a watcher's perspective. I've never actually played Demon Souls because I've never owned a PS3, so. So, here's our first boss fight. The Taurus Demon. I'm gonna make sure you come up here first and get rid of these skeletons, because these guys are a pain in the ass. I don't know if I ever mentioned this, but I'm using the washing pole, mainly because it has the speed of a katana, and it's also got that range, and because I have a magic build, somewhat, I've enchanted it, maxed it out, so I do pretty damn good damage with it. Pretty comparable to the Greatsword of Artorias, but... Alright, so... Once he appears, you gotta turn around and run all the way back. Because we're gonna stab this fuckface in the head. He won't catch you quick enough to hit you, so... Just come up here, two-hand this thing, jump off, attack. That's almost half health. And that one go. Alright, I almost died apparently. Awesome. You thought I was dead, didn't you guys?
That would have been embarrassing.
Yeah, would have been.
Oh well.
I'm actually getting my ass kicked pretty hard. I've never actually performed that poorly for the hunt. Oh well. Still got through it. Got in my humanity, my homeward bone, but the nice thing about my build, since I don't use homeward bones, got homeward. Don't need to worry about that shit. Let's keep pressing on here. Hopefully Drew and I can meet up to take on the next boss, since Drew decided to just rush on. Alright. It is a nice Solaire. He's kind of an interesting character. Or not kind of, he is, for sure. I think in the lore he's supposed to be like one of the... He's one of the potential firstborn son of Gwyn. Which... but I think... I don't know. Let me collect my thoughts here. Let's just talk to him first and we'll see.
You don't look hollow, far from it. I am Solaire of Astora, an adherent of the Lord of Sunlight. Now that I am undead, I have come to this great land, the birthplace of Lord Gwyn, to seek my very own son. You find that strange? Well, you should. No need to hide your reaction. I get that look all the time.
You'll find out later, this guy's batshit crazy.
Oh yeah, he is nuts.
The sun is a wondrous body, like a magnificent father. If only I could be so grossly incandescent.
I want that to be my senior quote. If only I could be so grossly incandescent. No one would know what the fuck I'm talking about.
What? I've just been dumbfounded.
Someone would come up to me and call me a fag. Somebody. I probably know who. Yeah, a little obsession with the sun. There's a great deal of this game being around fire, the theme of fire, I guess. Not really a theme, but... It's centered around that premise of fire, and he's so obsessed with the sun that he... The idea of him being the firstborn would make a lot of sense as him being, stripped of his status and then trying to reaffirm himself that way, but we'll see later what happens to him. This is like a Demon Souls callback. We have the Hellkite Dragon or whatever. I believe it's called the Hellkite Dragon. He toasts the bridge, takes out all the enemies, and now you're faced with the daunting task of trying to get to the middle of the bridge. So
this is very daunting.
Let's heal up and see if I can run across. I think the trick is, as Drew has pointed out to me before, to run on the left-hand side and then meet back at the right. So let's try it. If you do this, you shouldn't attack. Look at that, worked out perfectly. Now this is also an early game grind spot because what you can do is you can kick this ladder down. Rest of this bonfire, go back up, jump, walk onto the bridge for a second and then walk back down the stairs and that dragon will cook the entire bridge, killing every enemy, and then giving you and just the standard game about 550 souls, I think. Drew had just said before when we started it was about 2,500. Which, you know. This is only used, I think, to grind for souls to get the crest of Artorias. Let's open the forest. Oh, almost 3,000 souls, jeez. And once you get that, the forest is a much better grind spot, in my opinion.
It is. Really, really is.
On New Game Plus, the forest guys gave you about 18,000 per, so... Actually, I think this is where Drew and I can meet up for the first time.
Yes, it is.
Alright, so... Let's see...
Be up there in a sec, just messing around with some stuff. But I took the Ring of Favor Protection off, and I'm...
Ooh.
Put a new ring on, and I'm enjoying it.
Yeah, freedom. Free at last, free at last.
Might put it back on later, though. I don't even have another one, but... nice. My health is significantly lower, though.
Well...
Still have a ton of it, though.
Now you can
I don't really mind.
But now you can put on something like the Ring of Steel Protection and take less damage, so...
Trade off. Exactly, and still be able to move around really fast.
Yep.
I put on a different ring, though, actually.
Fair enough. Doesn't matter to me.
What do you want to...
So, we're gonna meet at the, underneath the bridge. We're gonna do some heroin downtown. And we're gonna take on the gargoyles, I think. Yeah. So, I'm gonna reverse hollowing. This is gonna be kind of standard for the whole thing. Is, I'm gonna go human. I'll bring in Drew to my game. We'll finish up my area, then I'll go back. And then I'll do it for Drew's game. And that's about how it'll work. And if I die, I will cut just the boss fight again, so you don't have to watch me backtrack all the way there. And Drew and I have had some pretty easy times finding each other to play this game. He usually puts his soap sign down once. If it doesn't work, he puts it down again, and we usually find each other in like about 2 minutes at most.
Hopefully it'll be pretty quick.
Yep. I think this one ended up being the longest at first, but then it just got quicker and quicker until it didn't matter. And in terms of humanity, I think I have enough to last the whole thing, as long as I don't die a bunch. Yeah, 45, regular, 9, twin, and I've never grinded for humanity, so if I ever needed I could grind rats, but hopefully it don't.
I could give you some, I got a lot.
Drew's also has a lot. Hopefully it doesn't come to that point, though, so...
Yeah, hopefully not.
as long as we're semi-successful...
I think it will.
As long as we're semi-successful, we're gaining humanity for the counter at the top left, and then humanity items for the bosses, so... We'll just be using the humanity counter... Humanity... So we don't have to actually use the items, so... Oh, is that you? Oh, here we go!
I'm being summoned.
By me. Alright, here we go. First area.
Get my new fun ring I got to put on, and I think you're gonna like it.
What's the ring? Is the one ring to rule them all? Is it? Is it? Give it to me. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Son of a bitch.
Love it.
Alright, let's go.
This light armor thing again, I like it.
Yeah, Drew went from like, I like armor, light armor, to I want a tank, to I want a light armor now.
I know. I don't know. I went in between for a little bit. But... I'm liking this light armor thing. It's fun.
It's definitely good stuff.
It's not as practical in any means, though. It's like, if you're having any problems, just tank it. Like...
Yeah, for sure.
I just started doing some PvP, and I got really into this witness.
Yeah, it ends up making your recovery...
Enemies don't give a shit about how fast you are.
Yeah. It ends up making your recovery frames... you have less recovery frames and your startup's quicker on that. Yeah, frame data.
Are we gonna go fight the Black Knight?
Fucking A, we are.
Do we kill this Black Knight?
Oh god, he already knows I'm here. What's up, bro? Jesus Christ.
Oh Christ, he's knocking me the fuck over. Oh.
Oh! Really? Like I said, New Game Plus. They don't give a fuck.
Dude, you just launched me in the air.
You did it again?
Yeah, you killed me.
Let's walk slowly here, kids. Not get murdered. Oh shit. Probably gonna miss. Oh wow, that move. Backstab him. Yeah, I
want you to. Yeah, get out of here.
Covered.
Nope.
Oh,
real quick hits.
Look at that. Alright, got a Black Knight Greatsword. Even though I've already got like 5. Actually, pretty sure I can't wield it either.
I can wield it. In fact, I have one.
No way.
Yeah, let's just backstab you.
This game's so metal. I'm gonna fuck your endurance over. Watch out. I'm gonna go lure the boar over. Maybe I'll get a crazy helmet. Can't see. Did that come over? No. Motherfucker. Shit. Backstab's butt! You did backstab's butt! I'm backstab's butt. I didn't backstab's butt! Watch out.
Oh, I said difficult to backstab him in his butt right now.
Careful there. What are you doing? Ah, butt. Stick it in that
done.
Ass.
I'll
take,
go.
Take the temperature. Oh, he dropped the helmet.
Take that temperature. You always get that helmet, I don't know why. I never get it.
It's really not amazing, but...
kinda good for early game stuff, but...
pretty heavy. I think it's like 26 pounds or something like that. Something stupid. You alright over there?
Yeah, it's getting kinda beat up, but it's whatever.
1600 health. We didn't actually make the mean to do that, but alright. Jumping! Alright. Let's keep on going. I'm rocking and rolling. Wait on Drew. I feel like I'm a mix between an anime character and a Mortal Kombat character.
Oh, fuck you. Getting souls.
Watch out.
What? I hit him before he hit me.
Mystery. It unlocks a mystery. I'll unlock some mystery machine so we can get in. Go solve a mystery. That'd be kinda cool.
What is that? I don't remember what that door leads to.
Stuff.
Nice little fun thing up here, you can backstab this guy. I like this part.
Dum,
little
dum, 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 dum. Hey buddy.
Boom!
And there's his shield. Oh wow, whoa! Ragdoll!
What?
Oh, you'll see, you'll see.
Well, yeah, if I do it right, I can just like flip him out of the ground.
Oh, you flipped him pretty far, it was pretty good.
Yeah,
so that night shield was pretty good, until I found the blood shield, I think that's what I was using for most of the game. Until I realized I was reading stats wrong, so... yeah, Maybe I'll let you in on that little adventure of how I misread.
One to right, you go to the left.
Yeah, maybe I'll let you guys in on the adventure I had misreading shield stats for a whole game. I'm gonna open this gate while you guys you do that with the skeletons.
You go ahead and do it.
I shall. Stop! This is a halberd over here. These weapons are actually pretty good, I just never really used them except for the scythe, because I wanted to look like the Grim Reaper.
You didn't want to look like the Grim Reaper, you know?
I don't know.
Let's be honest here. Oh, that wasn't good.
Ooh, I got humanity for that. Alright. Let's see if the guy knows. Sneak up on him. Fuck it. Damage. Got the basement key here.
Alright.
Let's go back to that. Opening that gate, making a little shortcut for us, kinda how this game works. If you ever played a Souls game before.
Game in the beginning of the game is all about shortcuts. You need to do as many shortcuts as you can.
I feel like most of the game's about shortcuts. Demon's Souls was more level based, obviously, and you would go through one level and open some. Should I summon a third wheel?
Go for it. Let's get a third party member in here.
It's better than the Knight of Solaire.
Oh yeah.
Even though Knight of Solaire is bro.
Been invaded.
Unstoppable.
Here, heal up real fast.
Go. Well, it's 3-on-1, so.
Good luck.
Yeah, good luck, that fucker.
Where's this guy's gonna come from first?
I don't know, I really don't care. I have a big hat.
Magic up my sword and spin around him and shit. Do it.
He's trying to walk to the doors. I'm not really quite sure where he is. Did I not summon this guy?
Oh, he's coming.
Oh, do you see him?
No. Oh, yes, I do.
Oh, hey, whoa, god. He has, like, no health.
Go kill him.
Okay. I kill him?
About to. Got pyromancies. Really good ones. In fact, I'm about to die.
He has a lot of health.
Oh my god. He just killed me.
What the hell?
He actually might be cheating.
Might be.
20,000 damage to him. That guy is cheating as shit. The guy is getting literally thousands of damage done to him.
Oh, he died. He died.
What the fuck?
I got him. I wonder how many souls this guy has. 1,985. Awesome.
What?
Piece of shit. Well,
right, well, I'm really close to where you are, so I can actually, I rested a fire link, so I already have a shortcut unlocked, so I'll just meet you up in, like, 2 seconds.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna actually do that shortcut, and then I'll go back to where we were just fighting, so.
Alright, I'll meet you there.
Did you already kill the big monster guy?
Oh, the one, the fire keeper soul?
Yeah. You son of a bitch.
Dealt with.
Alright, I'm gonna unlock this shortcut. First major shortcut of the game here. This is pretty good. Until you can warp.
Very important shortcut.
Indeed. Once you can warp, though, it's just... This game becomes...
Oh yeah, this game gets way better once you can warp.
Infinitely better when you can warp.
I kinda understand why it is this first part like this, though.
Yeah, I mean, you could warp.
Makes a lot of sense.
If you could warp from the beginning, this game would be too easy. But I can homeward, so I can technically kind of warp.
I just bought a bunch of homeward bones.
Never have to do that. Oh, look at these ugly faces. I mean, he's not ugly, it's just so... Everything else is so high detailed, and then you look at your character's face, and you're just like, oh,
Aw. It's a bit of a disappointment. Oh god! Dying the dumbest way possible.
What'd you do?
Rolled off one of those elevators.
Oh!
Oh well.
I'm gonna keep going. Hope I don't get invaded again.
Go back, grab my humanity, and then...
Yeah, if
human you up.
Yeah. You need to... Well, yeah.
I'll be up with you in a sec, because I'm just a dumbass.
Alright.
Excuse me for that.
Yeah, we all make mistakes.
Ew. Bloodstains up here.
Oh god.
Elevator trips here.
Hate this part.
Technically, I don't need to become human right now because.
No, you don't.
But that was. Right, well, I'll just meet you right outside the parish. I'm gonna kill them, big guys.
This guy's a pain in the ass. This guy's probably strong in magic. This probably isn't super effective. Oh, I got him!
Alright, so, put my, sign down right outside the entrance to the parish.
The entrance to the parish?
So you know.
Like, where that Black Knight Tower is?
I don't know, just like...
Oh, the...
What?
So I thought you meant the end
of... we just had the PvP fight.
Okay,
like,
yeah.
Right there.
That's not... This isn't a parish. Alright.
Yeah, I'm being summoned.
Bringing you in here.
My ass in here.
That guy had a lot of health. He ended up killing himself. This is the one guy I was trying to summon before. He's got like Ornstein and Silver Knight armor. Silver Knight armor.
Pretty good.
He looks cool, but...
I can't
quite summon him, so... Get a rockin.
I love this. I do a backflip, and then I do like this rush forward stab.
Alright.
Nuts doing it. Oh, you killed all these zombie guys.
I did.
Step ahead of me.
Yeah, these guys are a pain.
Kill the channeler?
Fucking hell,
dude. Did.
Guys are a pain in the ass.
It is.
Never liked dealing with them.
I can still will full giants. Have anybody bitch at me? But wait.
I think you can. What's your endurance is higher than mine. Yeah, you totally
yeah,
can.
Yeah, I can still do the medium roll.
Hey, and if anybody says, I mean, the medium roll will get you by in this game. You don't need to be super light. It's kind of
oh, dumb. Yeah. The fast roll is fun and all, but it's kind of dumb.
It's a misleading thing. When I first started this game, I definitely was like, oh, I gotta roll fast and have a big sword and do stuff. Which some people do, and some people make it work. That's fine, but, you know. Wasn't me. I'm a guy who likes balance when he plays characters. Anything.
Yeah. I'm only gonna use this giant's armor for the boss fight, because my rule about giant's armor now, at least for this playthrough, only for the boss fights.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna stick with what I got on. Kitties. I'm actually
Camp.
I'm gonna summon the Knight of Bro Lair.
Bro Lair, homeboy over here.
Got home slice.
Main man. The later. Yeah!
Love it. It's my favorite gesture.
Pretty good. Dragon Crest Shield off.
I'll wait till you get it. Everybody's out!
Do it.
Oh, you can kind of see the health bar. That's funny. clipping.
Clipping. Come on, gargoyles, let's go. Let's tangle. Let's bounce. Let's fight.
It's a really weird noise.
Squeezing.
Yeah, it's like you're squeezing or stretching or something. They're made of like rock. Or you're like crumbling and stuff. So, a good strategy if you don't have a buddy like mine is just go human and just summon the nice lair. He's a good bolt bag.
Yeah, he's the best bullet ever.
Oh, fuck.
Stop.
Drink. So a good thing to do is to cut off the tail pretty quickly. Like that. Get some good shit for it. Wow, we do way too much damage.
You.
The second one's more of a bitch because he breathes fire. It goes pretty damn far. Okay.
Matter though, because we're gonna kill him really hard.
That's how that works.
This is how that works. Look at that. Look at that.
20 million in the middle. Yep. That's how it works. 53,501. That's a really awkward number.
Yeah, 26,751.
Yep.
I don't know that. What does that even mean?
I don't know.
Understand. Get it.
Doesn't matter. Alright, I'm gonna ring the bell and I'm gonna go down to Undead Parish. Rest the bomb.
Undead Parish right now. Go human and then you can help me.
I'm already human. So. Oh, you gotta go human, yeah. So.
Yeah, I still gotta go human. I'm not gonna go human. Yes.
Guardian. Oh, man. Oh my god, I love the visual presentation of this game. Just gonna turn the HUD off and then. I wish I could play the game this way, but I totally would suck if I did it this way. Just like.
Hold on a second.
Alright, I'm gonna pull this and while we wait for him. Let's go rest at the Undead Parish. While we wait for Drew. We're gonna meet a character here, one of Velka's followers. I'm not super clear on all the lore in this game, so I'm not super informed on Velka.
Greetings. I am Oswald of Kareem, the Path.
His mouth doesn't move.
Now I shall reverse my hollowing.
Yet magnanimous.
Fight again.
Mm-hmm. Or to accuse. Or indeed all sins.
Jake, are you there?
Maybe.
Oh ho ho. Well, maybe me. I need definite answers. The world of maybes. Can't do this to me, Jake. I just can't.
So I'm only doing this out of love, Drew. Okay?
Love.
Trust me. Trust me.
What kind of love is this?
It's tough love, Drew. Tough. Love.
Toughest of love.
Mm-hmm. This guy sells you some stuff. This Velka's talisman, which... Yeah. Stuff. Oh, this is actually...
Already gotten invaded.
Very gesture.
So if you want to come here.
Alright then. Welcome. I'll be there in a second.
Anytime.
Hmm. Nope. Alright, I'm gonna head down there and I'll put my sign down for you so I can see if I can help you out. Okay. Hopefully it's not the same dude.
Oh, it's like Dentist somebody. I don't know what the fuck his name is.
Dentist. My arch rival. Yeah. Alright. I got a big hat. I killed Big Hat Logan. Big Hat Logan went deep shit. Spoiler alert. Alright, I'm going to where you were, and putting it down.
Right, well, me and this guy are gonna fight, apparently.
If you'd see.
Oh, bitch.
What's up? I have a hat.
Turn right here.
Your move!
Beer. Shbag. I'm not coming in. I don't think he's dead, so I'm not gonna go fight those knights on top of that guy.
Whatever.
That's just a bowl of bad ideas.
It's a bowl of soup. What kind of soup?
A bowl of soup.
What kind of shitty soup? Yeah, it's shit soup. Shit stew. Whatever. It's a bowl of shit stew. I don't like it.
Bitch. Fuck you. God damn it, my buffs are wearing off.
Oh no, you got one of the knights to come over here. Don't die in 2 hits from my sword.
Kill them all and hit anyways.
Probably die in less hits from yours.
Come here, bitch.
Now what? Your plan has failed. Yep. And back outside. Come on, bro. Well, apparently don't have any crystal spear, so that's cool. Don't care.
Yeah, he's not maximizing his opportunity for chaos. Like, he's trying to create chaos here. He's not doing a very good job of it.
Chaos. Hey, buddy, magic. How do you feel about magic?
Oh, fuck.
Do I have it?
You're hey, that knight.
I shall.
You just probably charge him.
Don't. Hey, you. I'm gonna go run back.
All right. I'll just keep him in here in the meantime.
Smart move, kids. This is expert Dark Souls playing, kids.
Coming up back, he's coming up back.
Does he know? Does he know? Does he know? Does he know? He totally knows.
He does. Deal with this knight now, though.
Now he's going around back. Oh, no he's not. Now he's going back in front. Now he's coming back.
I'm in front now. Ah, shit. Let's just regroup, Jake. Back to the spot where I summoned you.
That's kind of... Oh, he fell off the edge! He just rolled right off the edge.
He died when he was humanity.
I'll stand near where I think he died. That's pretty good.
Oh, I don't get it because he fell off.
Rolled right off the edge. Whoop!
Yeah, there's a... So I could summon somebody to fight.
Is it a dude with, like... Just summon the bro lair. He's too good.
No, it's like not... Like it was a summon, an invader.
Oh.
No, you do that. I feel like you just get ripped, owned to pieces. They just stand right behind you and just kill you.
Fuck your endurance.
God. Die. Rory, just shut up. I'm seriously sick of it.
I'm gonna cast this just for defensive purposes, kids. Motherfuckers. Oh, yeah. Magic! Probably really wasting this humming crystal soul mass, but whatever.
How do we use it in the boss fight?
Backstab. Yeah, I wasn't gonna use it in the boss fight, for sure. Where'd the Chandler go?
Exactly, so. Hey. I don't wanna kill him. Fall off the edge?
Possibly. Oh, you've been invaded again.
Oh, wait, no. In front of us, I guarantee you he's in front of us.
What, the guy?
Vader, yeah.
You watch hit that then, I'll stand around here-ish.
Shut up, for the love of God, just shut up!
Your cat is ridiculous.
Vader!
For those who don't know, Drew has a cat who, when he is playing late at night, she will come up to him and meow, constantly. Just non-stop. And there's no way to stop it. Like, he pets her, I assume he feeds her, he does all sorts of things.
The only thing I can get her to shut up is if I go to bed, but, like, then...
Yeah, he's a little busy.
Vicious fucking circle. Just... Well, let's try. Okay, let's go up. Let's just go up.
Alright, whatever. Yes, if he's up there, then, we can just fight him. be. I can probably see him from here, actually. Oh! What the hell?
It's above us. He's in a little outpost. Like, I know about this spot.
Alright then, I'll. Found the Chandler! I'm gonna take care of the Chandler. Fuck now.
We have to deal with him again, which is nice.
Nope. So, how do we deal with this guy?
I don't know, I have to wait. Can do, unless you want to cast magic back at him, or you're gonna have to waste some magic.
You get him to miss is the best thing. But.
Yep.
There you go. There you go. I can waste the healing. He gets 10 at most. Here, just don't move. That move's easy as shit to dodge, especially with your roll.
Watching him.
Watching.
Come at me, doing the come at me thing. I'm like, I'm not coming at you. How dumb do you think I am? Like an asshole.
This is why we don't like PvP.
This is exactly why we don't like PvP, because this shit happens all the time. Like, I don't really mind when somebody has, like, once an etiquette battle, you know, when they get together and they make sure you clear all of the enemies, and they get a big space, and take a bow, and you buff up, and then you play and shit. That's fine, but this shit? Shit's just annoying. Because
yeah,
I'm in a stuck, like, I can't do anything. I have to wait for him to come down for me to progress. Just all dependent upon somebody.
Yep. Do I have to be on the top ledge to make the jump? Like, I don't know, I have no idea what he's doing.
Go up here, you go up this one floor. Goes around, back.
Oh.
Look directly up, you can see him. Kinda standing above us right now, watching us. Can't really do anything about it. See him?
Yeah, I do. Oh. How quaint.
Trying to coax him into something.
How about I do that instead?
Oh, I suck at that. Yeah.
And that is how we deal with our problems.
Takes the best. That's how we deal with this shit. Like low-level invaders.
I guess. That guy only has like 615 health. That's half, more than half.
I guess it's people using cracked red eye orbs. Apparently those do not have any scaling at all. You can just invade anybody. That was really dumb to invade us.
I guess. Bro Lair, what's up, buddy?
Hi to Bro Lair.
Funny story, when we first did this, when we first started playing the game together, I had summoned him, and then I went to backtrack to go get something. And we came back, and he was just stuck on the ladder, and he wouldn't come down, and he wouldn't go up. And we had to reload the game to get him to move, for to go away, so we could continue on with the game. So, you know, broken shit. This is Dark Souls. Tis to be expected.
If we can skip this one, Jake.
Yeah, we've already seen this once, so.
Action buttons.
You guys have already seen it once. I don't know what I'm doing. How do this? How much damage does this do? I did that. I switch back to this. And I got two-handed bitch, and I'm just like, damage. Fuck you. Yep.
That was pretty easy.
That's how we do that.
Exactly how we do that.
Alright then.
That's 20 humanities.
Alright, 26751. I got 4 humanity off now. That's pretty good.
Bill.
So now that we've done that, I think our next thing would be to go take on the Moonlight Butterfly, you think?
Yeah, probably.
Alright. So Moonlight Butterfly.
We could even do Sif. We can knock out that if we wanted
to. Ooh, that's I don't know about that one. That one might have to wait. I'm gonna go rest at the Undead Parish and,
go real fast.
Basically the Andre bonfire. I can hear you ringing the bell.
Yeah, you can.
And, yeah.
Those of you who don't know, the cool thing that people in Dark Souls did in this game is if you are online and people do similar events that you've done in the world, like big event like ringing the bell, then game, you can hear when other people have done it as well. So when you ring the bell, everyone around you in that area also hears that you've rung the bell. Kind of cool.
It is. This game has nice little details like that.
It does.
And that has bad frame rate, so evens out.
It also has that, but you know, win some, you lose some. Back to life, man.
Can't be perfect. I think I'm gonna put another point to intelligence. I just wanna try to get to 50 so I can see what that one spell does and just do more damage overall with my enchanted washing pole. Might put more dex, just a plus 15 one's better too, but we'll see. Strength I'm not really worried about anymore because I don't really use a lot of strength focus weapons. It's more Drew's department.
Yeah, big physical heavy hitter guy.
And then
I'm
once
doing pretty quick speedy kind of bullshit right now, but still.
Yeah, he was a tank for a good long time. Now, I think I'm gonna get to 50 intelligence, then I'm gonna worry about endurance and vitality. Mostly vitality. But yeah. You think this is a good place to call it?
Well, yeah.